solve Viardot problem 147. In this, there are two particles in a frame of reference K. K is a stationary frame of reference, and the velocity of the particles in this frame of reference is V1 and V2. Mass is M1 and M2. There is another reference frame K dash, which is moving with a velocity V. So the velocity of the particle M1 and M2 in this frame will become, whenever frame moves with velocity V, here the velocity will become V1 minus V for M1, and for M2 it will be V2 minus V. In this frame of reference, when you look from that frame of reference, that is how you will see the velocity of 2. How we have arrived at that? V half M1 V1 minus V whole square plus half M2 V2 minus V whole square. This is the kinetic energy in frame K dash, which is moving. We have to find the velocity of the frame K dash such that the kinetic energy of this system is minimum here. So in such cases, always differentiate this value, which is to be maximized or minimized, and differentiate in respect to that value for which the maxima or minima is to be found. So dKe upon dV will be equal to 1 upon 2, take common, it will be twice M1 V1 minus V, differential of further this will be minus 1, plus twice M2 V2 minus V into minus 1. Put it equal to 0 to find maxima minimum point, we get M1 V minus V1 plus M2 V minus V2 is equal to 0. So V would be equal to M1 V1 plus M2 V2 upon M1 plus M2 is the value of V. Now what is V1 minus V? V1 minus V would be equal to V1 minus M1 V1 plus M2 V2 upon M1 plus M2. That V1 M1 will get cancelled, so it will become V1 M2 minus V2 M2 upon M1 plus M2. So V1 minus V would be equal to M2 into V1 minus V2 upon M1 plus M2. This is the value of V1 minus V. Similarly, V2 minus V we can find, and V2 minus V would be equal to V2 minus M1 V1 plus M2 V2 upon M1 plus M2. This would be equal to V2 M2 will get cancelled, so it will be M1 V2 minus M1 V1 upon M1 plus M2. This is V2 minus V. Now whether it is maxima or minima at this point, let us again differentiate it. So d square e upon dv square, d square ke upon dv square is equal to 1 upon 2. This will become twice m1, and when differentiated it becomes twice m2. This is greater than 0 because masses are greater than 0. It means the value of V which we found will give the minimum KE. Now what is that value? We can find, we have found V1 minus V, V2 minus V. This was V1 dash and this is V2 dash. Energy was equal to half M1 V1 dash square is equal to M2 square into V1 minus V2 whole square upon M1 plus M2 whole square. plus half m2, and this is equal to m1 square v2 minus v1 whole square upon m1 plus m2 whole square. So this comes m1 m2 upon 2 m1 plus m2 is common, and v1 minus v2 whole square is also common. This is square, this square is common, and v1 minus v2 whole square is equal to v2 minus v1 whole square, because we are squaring it. So minus will become, even if you take minus 1, it will be plus 1. So these values will remain same. So whether we write v1 minus v2 or v2 minus v1 whole square, the point is same. It becomes m2 plus m1. So it becomes m2 plus m1 gets cancelled here. So m1, m2 2 also gets cancelled on m1 plus m2 into v1 minus v2 whole square. So this is the value of the velocity, and 2 has not got cancelled. 2 was not getting cancelled, so 2 will remain. This m1 m2 upon m1 plus m2 is nothing but the reduced mass. So we write it as mu upon 2 into v1 minus v2 whole square is the kinetic energy in this reference frame, which is moving with velocity v, and this is the reduced mass mu. So that's all. Thanks.